As-sadaqatu al-jariya, as in the hadith. Would it help the non-Muslim? Very smart question. The answer is there. In Surah An-Nisa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَٰلِكَ لِمَن يَشَاءُ. If the parent was Muslim, but he may used to drink, he've committed adultery, he dealt with whatever, so the continuous charity would help him because he died as a Muslim, as a believer, yani, even if he's a sinner. And the prayer of his family members, of his sons and daughters, of his loved ones, of any person would benefit him. Yes, it would benefit him. But look at this. مَا كَانَ لِلنَّبِيِّ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَن يَسْتَغْفِرُوا لِلْمُشْرِكِينَ وَلَوْ كَانُوا أُولِي قُرْبَى مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُمْ أَنَّهُمْ أَصْحَابُ الْجَحِيمِ. It's over. If somebody died in a state of kufr or disbelief, he is not eligible for intercession, for forgiveness, for mercy. This is not our statement. Read the following ayah if you have a chance, because we ran out of time, about Ibrahim alayhi salam not being able to seek forgiveness for his own father after he died as a disbeliever. That applies to if somebody died as a shaheed, he will intercede for 70 of his family members, not including the kuffar. A hafiz al-Quran, a very righteous person, he would have been much more worthy for Prophet Muhammad to benefit his own parents. Is there anyone who's much more righteous than Prophet Muhammad? Or for Prophet Nuh to benefit his son? Or for Prophet Ibrahim to benefit his father? Or for Prophet Lut to save his wife? And many other stories.